Hey, J-Shrek, let's talk about e-bikes and how fun they are, because they're absolutely one of the funnest things I've bought forever. Now, if you're not familiar with me or my channel, we do adventure riding out in the wilderness of the Southwest. We do a lot of fire roads. We do a lot of single track. So our bikes are actually fairly extreme. And what I wanted was a motorcycle that was extremely light, quiet. I didn't have to pedal if I didn't want to, and I could haul cargo and or gear. And so that's why I chose an e-bike, something that, you know, a lot of people think, well, a motorcycle would be good. But then again, you're dealing with 300 or 400 pounds. I wanted a, you know, even though an e-bike is heavier at 85 pounds, it was a perfect example of a light motorcycle for me. That's why I chose it. The second thing I needed was I needed distance. So I chose a bike that would get me 90 miles. And so I have the best of both worlds. So that's the way I look at the choice that I made. I bought a Biketrix Juggernaut Ultra Full Suspension 3, Pro 3. It just came out in 2023. They've had older models or versions up to that. Now I chose a full suspension bike, and that's for a reason as well. I have a mid-drive, and I chose that for a reason as well. So let's go back to the little bit of the history that why I chose what I chose. The first thing that to remember is that I was looking for something that I could just throw off the back of the truck. I wasn't going to have to drive, you know, take the beating on some of these fire roads that I was on my truck to get pinstriping, all Arizona pinstriping, what they call it, going through places. And I wanted to get there at a fairly quick rate. So I decided that an e-bike would fit me perfect. The first thing I thought was that the basic bike that I was looking at was like a $1,600. And I was like, I really don't want to spend that much money for a bike that I don't really know if I'm going to like. And so what happened with me was that I found a used one off Craigslist. It was a hay bike and no rear suspension. It had front suspension, and I bought the bike. And I absolutely fell in love with this bike. I loved it. It was absolutely awesome. But what I learned as I had this bike is that components, I learned about the bike itself. I learned hub drive versus mid drive. I learned all these things that were going to help me as I made my decision. And when I finally made my decision, what I did was I decided that because I loved it, I was willing then to go to the next level, which was a lot more money. But I knew that if I wanted a bike to do what I wanted it to do, then I was going to have to step it up. And the fact was, the cheaper bike, even though I loved it, the braking system was not very good. And that's not something that you want to have a problem with. I did enjoy the hub motor, even though I'll tell you and explain to you why I went with a mid-drive versus a hub. And I wanted something that would last, and I wanted to get support from people that I could communicate with, which I hadn't been able to do with other brands when I was looking to buy this motorcycle. I say motorcycle, this bicycle, because I look at this as being actually a class 3 bike. There are three classes to e-bikes. There's class 1, which is pedal assist, means that you have to pedal it, but you get assistance and a top speed of 20 miles an hour. A class 2 is basically the same bike with a throttle, and a class 3 is 28 miles an hour basically with a throttle, and you don't have to pedal if you don't want to, same as a class 2. Just a more speed basically. So those are basically your three, and it might change in your state, so make sure you check that. E-bikes are kind of an under the radar kind of thing that probably there's going to be more regulations, but that's why I chose the Biketrix, because I could communicate with them. There were two bikes I was looking at, and the reality of it was that I went with one that I could get communication with, because I didn't want to spend the kind of money I knew I was going to need to spend to get the right components, and I wanted to be able to talk to somebody.